All right, ladies and gentlemen, today we have a slightly different video than normal. Today we're going to be doing an Arsenal tier list, but for the game modes of Arsenal. Now, I have done an Arsenal tier list in the past, and in that video, I did a tier list for the maps and the weapons of Arsenal. I went through pretty much every single weapon that Arsenal has and every single map that Arsenal has at that time. The only thing I forgot really in that video was to do one based on game modes. So in this video, I am going to be doing a tier list based on all the game modes in Arsenal. So if you guys do end up enjoying this video, then make sure to go ahead and drop a like on it and subscribe for some more videos like this. And let's go ahead and get started. So I was the one who actually created this tier list right here, the Arsenal game modes tier list. That's why the images are terrible. So you can't really see some of them, but I'll just read them to you as I go along. All right, so the first mode we have, you can't really see it, but this is kill confirmed. Now, kill confirmed is not in the current public rotation, but I really don't mind kill confirmed. It was a pretty fun mode. I feel like it could be improved a little bit, but it wasn't that bad of a mode. It was pretty fun, and it was a mode that actually kind of encouraged teamwork in Arsenal. And because of the teamwork encouragement, and for it being a pretty solid mode, I'm going to go ahead and give it a B. The next mode that we have is gun rotation. And I think most of you know how I feel about gun rotation. Personally, I will never vote this mode. If you get a weapon that you hate, you're stuck on it for 20 seconds. And then to make matters worse, there's a golden knife kill at the very end. If it was a golden pistol kill, I might not mind it as much. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm not going to give it an F tier. I'm going to go ahead and just give it a D tier because it's not a terrible mode. I just don't really like it. The next mode that we have is Concussion Mania. Not that bad of a mode. I don't really play it that much. Or I don't really like to play it that much. It's a fast paced mode, but it can be fun. And it was a mode for the longest time that people were trying to set records on. It's a good mode. It's not that bad. It's pretty fun, but I don't really like it a lot. I'm gonna go ahead and just give it a C tier. All right, the next mode, you can't even read this one at all, but the next mode is Sword Fights mode. Sword Fights mode isn't that bad. It can be fun, but it does get kind of repetitive fast. Like, I can only play like one or two games of it in a row, and then I'm going to start getting bored of it. But it's not a terrible mode. I'm going to go ahead and just give this one a C tier as well. I'll just put it right in the middle. All right, so pistols only. This mode's pretty fun. You just go through all the pistols of Arsenal, and this kind of makes me wish that there was other modes like this. I wish we had like a snipers only mode, or like a rifle only mode, or a shotgun only mode. Pretty fun mode, though, and it is one that's kind of more difficult because you can only use pistols in the game. Not one of the best modes, but it is pretty solid as well. So I'm going to go ahead and give this one, I was thinking a B tier, but I'm going to go ahead and give this one a C tier as well. All right, our next one is competitive. And you already know competitive is my favorite mode in the game. This one's definitely going to be an S tier for me. You get the good weapons, all the hit scan weapons in Arsenal, and it ends off with that golden gun kill. It's like the perfect mode, the perfect Arsenal mode for me. The next mode is bows only. Now, everyone hates Arsenal bows, but the fact that there was a game mode in the game for bows only, which was I think done for a troll for John Roblox, for there being a bows only mode, everyone was forced to a bow, so it wasn't that bad. It wasn't like torture like on standard, where if you get a bow, everyone's on better weapons and you're just gonna keep dying. So everyone was forced to bows. I didn't really mind it. It was actually kind of fun. I would actually still play it if it was in the game, not gonna lie, and people might hate me for this, but I would give this one a B tier. It was kind of a good mode to help practice your bow skills for when you do play on standard and get a bow. All right, so the next mode is Clown Infection. Clown Infection, great mode as well. It's more of like a, I guess, like a party mode. People like to play this on streams. Mr. Bald Wake likes to always play this on his streams. When you're one of the last people, it's really intense. It's just so much fun to sit there and shoot hordes of clowns running at you. I would give this one an A tier. All right, so the next one we have Headshots Only. Now, this is pretty much just competitive, but it's locked to only being able to get headshots. Also, one of my favorite Arsenal modes, probably my second favorite Arsenal mode. Definitely gonna give this one an S tier next to competitive. All right, the next mode is Brick Battle. Now, Brick Battle isn't bad, but that bomb that you have to get, very annoying. I don't like the bomb at all, and it ruins pretty much the whole entire game mode for me. I'm gonna give this one some pity, but I'm gonna go ahead and just give it a D tier. But it's not like horrible. I just don't like the bomb. All right, the next mode is laser tag. Now, laser tag is kind of a cool concept and it can be kind of fun, but at the same time, the laser guns just destroy your PC. And no matter how good your computer is, usually no one's computer can really handle this mode. It just completely destroys your FPS and you can't really enjoy it when you're getting like 10 FPS. If that was fixed though, it'd be a better mode, but because it's not really a playable mode, in my opinion, I'm gonna give this one an F tier. If it was playable, I would probably give it around C or a B. All right, the next mode on the list is Railgun Royale. Now, this is a fast-paced one-tap mode. A lot of fun. One of my favorite modes as well. Again, ends on the golden pistol. 10 out of 10 right there. I was thinking about giving this one an S tier, but I would go ahead and just give it an A tier because it's not one that I play all the time, but it is pretty far up there. It's probably my third favorite mode after these two. All right, so the next mode is, can't really see this one, but this one is Arcade. Arcade is pretty fun, but there's only one map for it, which is Lunar. And because of that, it kind of gets repetitive extremely fast. I'm gonna go ahead and give this one a C. If it did have more maps, it'd probably be like a B or maybe even an A. So the next mode is Hacula. Now, Hacula was an event mode and it's still in VIP servers. Now, this is something Arsenal has never seen and it was really cool and it was a lot of fun, but the fact that they had it in public servers for a very long time, it got very repetitive and annoying to get voted. But for it being new and something that was enjoyable, I'm gonna go ahead and give this one an A tier. The mode itself was really good and a lot of fun to play, and it was really cool to see something new in Arsenal. All right, the next mode is Typical Colors. Now, Typical Colors is another Rove game. They tried putting a mode in Arsenal for Typical Colors, but it didn't really work, I don't think. It just gave you weapons that Typical Colors had. I'm just gonna give this one a D tier, because it is an OG mode, but it's just like, eh. The next mode is Firework Launcher mode. This mode's annoying. All right, so Standard. Standard I have a love-hate relationship with. It was always the main mode before there was competitive and headshots only. I don't really mind Standard. There are a few weapons that really make me upset, and I don't like getting the Golden Knife kill. But Standard is still, you know, Standard Arsenal, and I still enjoy playing it. The Golden Knife kill is annoying, but I can look past that. I'll go ahead and just give it an A tier. All right, the next mode is All Weapons. Now, this mode was pretty cool. You'd get every single weapon in Arsenal, no matter what it was, even if it was removed from the game. They had every single weapon in here. I'd give this one an A next to Standard. Automatics, this mode isn't bad. It's kind of like a good mode if you're a noob to the game. Honestly, it's pretty fun to just use automatic guns and kind of chill. I'll give this one a B tier. The next mode is Juggernaut. Now, Juggernaut is a really fun mode as well, in my opinion. It's actually one of my favorite Arsenal modes. The only thing is that there are some weapons in Juggernaut that don't work for some reason and are glitched or broken. Besides that, though, very solid mode. I love playing Juggernaut. It's a lot of fun. I'm gonna go ahead and give this one an A tier. The next one is Randomizer. Randomizer is also a lot of fun. It is annoying when you get terrible weapons because you have to reset, but it is a lot of fun, and it's a lot of fun to try to set records on this mode. This one is an A tier as well for me. All right, so the next one is Wild West. This one just uses weapons in Arsenal that are pretty much Wild West themed, like the Spencer Carbine, the revolvers, stuff like that. I don't really mind this mode. It could be kind of fun. I'm gonna go ahead and just give this one a C tier. Not one of the best modes, but it's there and it can be fun to play from time to time. All right, so the next one is Knife Fight. Now, I don't really like Knife Fight just because of the fact that you're really, really fast when you play it. Your character speed is like 2 or 3 times what it normally is, and it makes it really annoying to actually get knife kills. Now, if there wasn't any speed to this mode, I would think it's a lot of fun because it forces everyone to use knives, but because there's that speed aspect to it, I don't really enjoy playing it, so I'm gonna go ahead and just give this one an F tier as well. The final mode is Counterblocks mode, which is pretty much like Typical Colors, except it just uses the Counterblocks weapons instead of it using the Typical Colors weapons. Kind of a cool concept, but if you want to play Counterblocks, or if you want to play Typical Colors, just go play those games. You don't really need an Arsenal mode for it, but it is cool that they tried to add that in. But this one is also a D tier next to Typical Colors. All right, and that's pretty much it. These are all the Arsenal game modes ranked from S to F. This is completely my opinion. You might not agree with me. So hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, make sure to go ahead and drop a like on this video and subscribe for some more videos like this. And let me know what you guys think down in the comments below if you agree with my tier list or if you don't. But anyways, I'll go ahead and see you guys in the next video. So goodbye.